Hello everybody, this is the Human Colony Saturday webinar. Today is February 11th, 2017, and we have an exciting mini channel panel set up today with three awesome channelers who are a part of the Human Colony community. So today we have with us NEIL333, and we also have Angie Marias and Brian Sims who have joined us. And kudos to Neil because it is extremely early in the morning for him to have joined. So good morning everybody and thank you for being with us. This is super exciting to get you guys on here. I'll quickly go through who is in the room here with us, although as we know that changes. Right now we have Angie and Brian, Carolina, Christine, David, Herkimer Diamond, Jana, Johannes, Michelle, Neil, Serena, Will, Sheena, and Damian just joined as well. So welcome everybody. And as far as us going, I will quickly go through some quick announcements as far as our calendar goes. We do have some upcoming events for Human Colony. You can go to humancolony.org to be able to check out what we have listed in our calendar. The upcoming events that we have is tomorrow we're actually having Brooke Alissom, who is being interviewed by, or not interviewed, but Max is hosting for her, and that will be on the 12th, Sunday at 1 p.m. Eastern. So that's going to be awesome. She is extremely connected to the divine feminine energies and the goddess energies. And also we have on Saturday, February 18th, Sean Swanson, the well-known channeler of Ishua of the Yahyel, is going to be joining us to channel, and Max and Jim are both going to be a part of hosting for him. So that will be at 5 p.m. Eastern, which is super exciting that he has come to join us. So please stay tuned for those events. You can go to humancolony.org/jump to get our participation links to be a part of these webinars and everything. You can also always go on our YouTube live pages and chat with us on the question or the little live chat box thing. So thank you everybody for your support. I also wanted to thank everybody who has been providing feedback for how we run these webinars. We are completely volunteer based, and we are just very lucky and blessed to even be able to put these together. So thanks for everybody sticking around and being a part of these and contributing your energy. If you would like to provide any more feedback about the webinars, you can send them to max@humancolony.org. And also with that said, we are looking for more hosts. I have been hosting because we haven't had anybody else to host, and I enjoy hosting, but we also need more people around to be able to help us out. So if you are looking to join us, and if you would be willing to host, we would be happy to teach you just clicking buttons and making sure things go smoothly. So please let us know if you're willing to help out with the hosting for webinars like these and other ones. You can email max@humancolony.org to get in touch to help out with that, and that is greatly appreciated. Last announcement, we are doing a book project, a Human Colony book project, and that is going to be for transcribing videos that our channelers, especially Jim, have channeled in Human Colony. The really important messages that need to be written out, and the same goes for messages in other languages too. If you are willing to translate or transcribe any of our videos, please let us know by emailing max@humancolony.org so you can get involved in that project. Every Friday we do a book meeting with Max and Jim. Jim is typically able to join, and we will go through the stuff then. We have volunteers for that as well. So let us know. Thank you for being involved in what we do. And I think that with all of that said, are there any other announcements from anybody here that anyone wants to go through before we get started?
Yeah, I'll make a few announcements. Yeah, just to let everybody know that I do like regular events as well. So usually like once a week I'll do an event, And when I do the events, I'll either run them on Google Plus or I'll run them on Facebook. So I'll do, like next week, I've got a Pleiadian healing event. I do regular healing events as well. So yeah, you can find, there's a link that I've got. I think Bree put it down in the description for everybody to see. So there's a link, there's a Facebook page. And if you go to that Facebook page, it's got like all my updates on it. It's got all the events that I do on it as well. So anything that I do, like any videos that I do, I'll get posted in there. And any events I do get posted in there. And that's all that I post. It's not like you're going to get junk mail or anything like that, or you're going to get like spam or anything if you join that page. So if you do want to keep up to date on all the stuff that I do, that's the best way to go about doing it. So that's all what I announced. So thanks very much for that, Bree.
Yes. Okay. Awesome. Thank you, Neil. Yeah, Neil does a whole lot of stuff, and he's been at this for a while now. So definitely check him out and our other channelers we have today. All the information, as he said, is down in the description of this video. So check these people out. You know, support people in our community. Support lightworkers and people who are doing this awesome stuff, because this is how we are getting things rolling. So wonderful. Then I think we can probably go right into it. At the end of the webinar, we can do some closing blessings. But I think just for the sake of time and making sure everybody has enough time to channel for us and everything, we're just going to go right into it. So if you are ready, Neil, then please go right ahead.
Right then, okay. So what I'll do is I'm going to bring my guides in first. I'll bring in my main guide. Sometimes when they come in, they talk as like a collective. So what I'll do is I'll bring them in first and I'll let them speak. When I'm channeling now, I'm doing it in more of a conscious way. I'm speaking it the way I want to speak it. And what happens a lot when I channel as well is you might notice it sometimes, because sometimes you'll notice a change in the vibration, or you'll notice a change in the tone, and there's different beings will slip in and they'll slip out. So that happens as well. So yeah, just feel free if you want to ask any questions. You ask whatever questions you want. And also, there might be, sometimes they do healing and things like that as well. And sometimes it's actually going on as I'm speaking as well. So if there's anything like that you need help with as well, you can ask for that also. I think they're going to give a short message at the start as well. I'm not quite sure exactly what it's going to be, but I think there's going to be a short message at the start as well. So, okay, it could take me a few minutes to get into this sometimes. So yeah, thanks for being patient. So I'll just get into it now. Okay. Oh, so they're just saying thank you everybody for coming together like this. when everybody comes together like this, it creates great waves, and it creates great ripples within the consciousness of many. Not just the ones that are watching this, but also the vibration that you're giving off. It affects all the people that are around you physically, and all the people that are connecting with you in ways that it's not in a conscious way, ways that are happening in the astral, yes, but also in ways that are happening in a subconscious way. Because what you're doing is you're putting out a vibration, and you're allowing others to come and to align themselves with that vibration. Now, even if people align themselves with that vibration, it's not completely in line with it, you've still got a way of giving out a frequency that allows them to pull closer to it. And that's what this is all really about. That's what this ascension is all really about, is getting everybody's vibration up and changing people's belief systems. It's a huge part of what the ascension is. It's basically what the ascension is about, is changing people's vibration and changing their belief systems. When you change your belief systems, it changes your vibration. They go hand in hand together. So your beliefs are very extremely, extremely important. And this is the whole reason for coming together at times like these, is for changing people's beliefs and changing people's viewpoints. Is a very, very important thing that needs to take place. So thank you once again for everybody coming together like this, because it creates such a beautiful change. It creates such a beautiful vibration that is radiated out. You feel it within yourself, yes. And it creates a shift within yourself, yes. But it also is, like we said, creating great, great shifts within others. So this is a way that you can work with others in an indirect way, is by coming together like this and by sharing the love that you have for each other and the love that you have for the messages. And this, in an indirect way, from your point of view, an indirect way, is actually creating great shifts and great waves. So the more often that this happens, the better it is for the ascension, and the better it is for each other as well, because many of you people that are coming together in these groups, you have very strong connections from other lifetimes, yes, but also recognize in this lifetime, you have very strong connections also. It's not that the connections were stronger there, they are not stronger here. They are just as strong here as they are when you are in the fifth dimension or you are in a fourth dimensional body. So recognize that you in this reality, in this lifetime, are very, very powerful also. And your bonds with each other are very, very powerful. When you recognize that, then you will feel it. Then it will pull you together tighter, for the bonds, the energetic links that you have with each other, these streams of energy flowing through all of you, these will be reinforced and they will be opened up. And as they open up, all of you will come together and all of you will work together as one. And this is very, very important to set this example for others. When you are coming together and working together as one, this sets a great example for others, for they see what can be accomplished when you do this. They see the vibration that is given off when you do this. And when people see that, then they will come into alignment with you. Then they will agree with what you are doing and their belief system. And that will allow their vibration to come into par with yours. This will allow others to feel it is acceptable and it is safe to connect with others in a very loving and a very full way. So these are very, very much example setters, and see yourself that way. Now, this should not put fear into you. This should not make you egotistical, but this should make you recognize that you have an important role in what you do. And that important role has a great effect on others in a very positive way. Now, the ascension itself, it may seem that the ascension right now is not going well, but if you can see what is going on, there is a great flow of energy that is taking place right now. And with that great flow of energy, it is kicking up all the sand that is at the bottom. And this sand, as it gets kicked up, it clouds the water. And this is only natural that this will happen. This has to happen for the whole of that area to be cleared of all the sand on the bottom, so it is a strong foundation that is left, a strong rock foundation that is left. And from that strong rock foundation, then there can be a rebuilding. Now, there are many, many things that are taking place right now in your media, also within individuals as well, and the energies that people are feeling as well. And this is because there is a great detox taking place. It is this idea that we have shared with you of the sand being kicked up. Now, it is your responsibility what it is that you align with. Will you align with the negative things which are being kicked up, or will you stay up higher towards the surface where the water is clear and where the water is flowing the fastest? That is your responsibility. Now, as a light worker, the responsibility that you have as a light worker is to do what is true for you. For when you do what is true for you, then you will be assisting humanity in the best way that you can. It is important for you to realize each one of you have a different role within the ascension. Yes, you're all working together as one. And yes, you're all working together for the same thing. But within that, there are many different roles. And that is a very important thing for you to recognize, because many light workers are trying to do the same as what they see others doing. And this is not the way to move forward. The way to move forward is to do what you feel is right for you, because you have your unique abilities and you have your unique perspective and you have your unique way of maneuvering through life. So it's very important for you to tune into that and to recognize what that is. For when you recognize what that is within yourself, then the confidence in yourself will be very, very, very clear to you. It will shine out very clear to you, and it will shine out very clear to others. And that is something which is also very important for others to see, that what you are doing with sincerity. That when you are expressing love, you express love through pure sincerity. That in itself makes a very big difference. And these are the tools that we are talking about that create the ripples. When people see this, when people are viewing you and they are seeing you are talking with honesty and you are talking with sincerity, and when you are coming together and doing this as a group, that is very, very, very powerful. And that is the direction that you are all moving in now. You are going through a learning process of how to do that. And yes, you will find that there are belief systems that will come up. Limiting beliefs, ones that feel heavy, ones that don't work with work when you are trying to work with each other in a community, yes, but it is about recognizing them. And this is an important point also, that recognizing that when you're shifting your vibration up, when you are coming together and you're all raising your vibration together, then there will be things which have to come out in the same way that things have to come out with humanity. As humanity raises its vibration, the same thing is happening within the spiritual communities. When the spiritual communities come and when they lift their vibration up, they'll also go through a detox process where individuals and negative beliefs will come out. This is not something that should be shunned, and it is not something that should be frowned upon. When you see this happening, it is a learning experience for all. Not just the individual which is experiencing it, but for the others as well. Now, have compassion when you see individuals like this, and have love for them, because they are going through an experience where they are detoxing. It is not to focus on the negatives, as we said before, but to focus on the positive and to see that person, yes, they are doing well, because they are getting to the stage where these negative beliefs, they are starting to come out now. They are starting to detox their system. So when you see this, offer support to others. Now, it's not to say that you have to push any of your beliefs upon that person, but by offering them support in the way of love and in the way of understanding that you will always be there for them, that helps these individuals, including yourself when it happens to you. That helps individuals to easily let go of these old beliefs. Now, as this happens, the more that this happens and the more assistance that's given from each other, the more that the spiritual communities will grow. And the more that the spiritual communities will grow, the stronger effect that will have on others, on the other parts of humanity who are also wishing to open up and who are also wishing to let go of their beliefs. So there is a great learning process, as we said, when this happens, when the detox of individuals happen, because humanity detoxing on a whole is humanity detoxing as individuals. I'll bear that in mind as well. So when there is a detox process happens within our individuals, within spiritual communities, when this happens, when you're observing it, it's important also to learn from the experience and looking at what is that person's belief system. Why is that person released? Why is that person acting in that way? Or when you start to do this and you start to understand, this will make it much easier for you to detox your negative belief systems, because many, many people have the same negative beliefs. This is something that is not true just within spiritual communities, but within the whole of humanity. There are many themes that humanity is going through as a group consciousness. So when you can observe others and you can see, yes, that person may be acting in a way that I don't like, but why are they acting like that? What is the belief that they have that is causing them to act in that way? When you look at it like that, and when you see it that way, you will start to understand, and you will let go of any judgments you have of that person, because you will realize and you will accept that, yes, that is not who that person truly is. That is just something that person's starting to let go of. They are bringing it up to the surface so they can let go of it. By doing that, you will hold the love that you have for that person, but also you will understand what the belief is. You will understand the signs on the patterns of that person's belief coming out. So when you see those beliefs coming out in yourself, it will be much, much faster. You will be much more efficient at knowing what the belief is. When you're acting in a way and after acting in a way that you did not like, and you're contemplating, why was I acting that way? Or why did I feel afraid at that time? Or why, or what? If you're feeling that and you're contemplating that, it's much easier, much, much easier for you to snap to that, to work with. That is what the belief is. If you have seen it in others before, if you have recognized it, and that's the important point, is to recognize it in others, to recognize it as beliefs. When you recognize it as beliefs, it cuts you off from the emotional attachment you have when you see other people acting in a negative way. So that is very important for keeping the vibration up within spiritual communities and within any communities. It is very important to bypass the emotional attachments you have when you see others acting negatively. It's very important to bypass them. Otherwise, your vibration gets lowered. It can affect others as well, and it can spread also. So by seeing others as humans as well, as equal to you and equal to all others, by seeing them that way and seeing that, yes, this stuff that's coming up is coming up in them for a reason. It's coming up because they're shifting the vibration up, and as they shift the vibration up, the negative beliefs are coming out. So when you see that, you can recognize that, and yes, that is a good thing that person's doing. They are working towards being a better person. And when you see it like that, when you see that they're working towards being a better person, then you will let go of any of the emotional attachments that you have, any of the negative emotional attachments that you have to that person. And you will look at it in a more analytical way. The love will be there with them, but when you're looking at the way they're acting, you will be looking at it in a more logical way. And when you look at things logically, when you can look at things and analyze things logically, is a very good technique of letting go of the emotional attachment you have to that thing, to that belief, and you continue that love, that underlying love that's always there, that you have for all people, for all beings, because fundamentally that is what is there with all beings. One moment, please. I need to take a drink. Okay. So yes, even as I'm saying this, even as I'm As these messages are being given to you, there is a bond that is coming closer within everybody that is listening, because this rings true to everybody, because it sings to your heart, and it sings to your heart what your heart actually feels. And as it sinks to your heart starts to open up. And as your hearts are all open up, everybody is coming together and everybody is bonding together because our people already are starting to let go of things. And this is very, very good. This is very good for bringing people together. Now, there's not. This is just natural. This is just the way that humans have acted naturally for a very long time. The light workers are going through a process right now, where they're going through a process of learning how it is. They're learning a new way of functioning in this reality, functioning not so much in this reality, yes, but let us put it like, they're learning a new way to function in their life, to function as higher dimensional beings. Now, this is not to say that you're becoming fourth dimensional within the space of a few years. That is not what we are saying. But for us to ascend to the fourth dimension, we must learn to act. We must learn to function in a different way, as different from the way that we have always been functioning. For if we continue functioning the way that we have always functioned, we will never ascend. We will never go through that vibrational shift. And that is what is taking place right now with the light workers. The light workers, they are learning how to function in a different way. Not only the light workers are doing this, we should also note that the whole of humanity is doing this as well. But the role that the light workers are playing is they are doing it in a way where they will, at a certain stage within the ascension, they will be able to help many, many others who also wish to start shifting their vibration rapidly. The learning process that's going on with the light workers is something that is going to be applied to others later. They're applying it to themselves and to others in light worker communities and in spiritual communities. But later, this will be something that they can apply to others when others also wish to start letting go of many of the beliefs and start to move into a new way of functioning. The light workers will be at a stage then where they will be able to help in a much more efficient way because they have done this so far. So they have done this already. So that's all that we're going to share today, because there's a lot of information in that, and it's been condensed as well when the information's been given, so that more information could be given in that period of time. So I would be advised to listen over it. Listen over what was said, because each time that you're listening over what is said, you'll notice new things in it. And as you progress as well, there'll be other messages that you'll see in it that weren't so obvious before. But that is okay, because that is part of the process, and that is part of the when that is happening, it is giving you a notice, or it is showing you that you are going through a progression in your beliefs and your understandings, and that is what this is all really about. So that is enough speaking for now, and for now we'll start to take questions from anybody who has any questions for us. So yes, feel free to ask anything that you wish.
Okay, thank you so much for those beautiful messages. Very important at this time, so we really appreciate it. We do have questions coming in. The first one we have is from Sheena. Are you able to unmute, Sheena? All right, I think she might be getting her microphone set up or something. Oh, wait, are you there? I see the icon turned Hello. Off.
Yes.
Hello. I can hear you.
Mm-hmm. Greetings.
Yes.
I'm wondering about something in the astral. sorry. Last night I was in astral for 12 hours, and I kind of knew what was happening. It's very seldom that I remember what happens there. Sometimes I do. It was like to be in a railway, you know, like or a subway they have in, you know, yes, underground in the United States.
Yes.
Everything happened there. I was wearing gray and black clothes. Everybody that was also with me was wearing that, and we had to run very fast, because there was I wonder who. And I think it has a connection with something that has standing outside my door, because there, you know, darker side. They just appear. I cannot see what it looks like. But I think it has to do some that. But I will ask you if you can look into that.
Okay, one moment. So when you said that, the people in the train station, that they had different colored clothes, did you say they had white and black? Is that right?
No. What was happening is that we were, underground.
Yeah,
I saw the clothing and those with me, and it was great, like long.
It's really hard to understand what you're saying, because it's breaking up. Every second word's breaking up. So,
okay.
All right, give me one moment. I'll tap in and see what I can get anyway.
Okay.
All right, one moment. Okay, so what they're telling me is this. So the reason that it was underground is because it's something in your life that you've got, it's like something that it's not hidden, but it's something that you're pushing down in your life. It's something that you're trying to avoid, and you're trying to push it down to avoid it. And that's why it's taking place underground. The reason that's the train station is because it's some sort of junction, or it's not so much a junction, but it's like, there's something that you need to do in your life, and you're trying to push this off by putting it down. And that's why you're in a train station that's underground. Now, one moment. There's something about it. I don't know what it is, but there's something about that dream, something in the dream that was scary for you. And whatever that is, that's part of the fear that you've got, that you're trying to avoid it. You're trying to avoid whatever it is. So that's all that's really coming through for it. But wait a minute, I'll see this.
It was no fear for me. It was somebody we needed to clear away. Task, if you understand.
Oh, it's Klask. One moment.
No, task. Like an astral task.
I can't make out what you're saying. I'm sorry, it's chopping up so much.
She said task, T-A-S-K.
Some task that you had to do. Right, okay.
Yes.
Okay, just give me a moment. Yeah, that's right. That's what they're saying. Because there's something that you need to do, and it's something in your life that you need to do, and you're trying to push this down, and you're trying to avoid it. It's like there is something that you need to do, and that's what the train is about. It's about you moving on that, taking that journey, and going and doing that thing, and you're not doing it. You're putting it off.
Okay.
Yeah, that's all they're giving me on it. So.
Yeah, because it felt like, you know, this matrix state, you know, not quite like in the movie.
Yeah. Yeah, they're not giving any more information on it. That's all they're saying.
Okay. Thank you, and much love.
Much love.
Thank you so much. We have a question from Symmetry on YouTube. Symmetry is asking if there are any messages for them from any beings, and much love.
Okay, one moment, please. There's some angels here that want to give you some messages. These angels, you've got some angels that are around you just now, and they've been there for quite a while. They're sending energies to you, and what they're doing is right now they're I don't want to say upgrading, it's not that word. It's like they're lifting your vibration up. They're sending you energy and lifting you up. It's a small group of them. One moment. There's three of them there. And these are not these. One moment, I'll see which ones there is. Michael's there with you, but the other two, I'm not quite sure who they are. Michael's the one that stays. He's sort of staying at the front, and the other two are sort of behind them. Excuse me, the other two are sort of behind them, but I don't think they are. They don't feel so much like famous angels. So he's saying that. Okay, so Michael's speaking now, and he's saying that what you can do is you can reach out to him if there's anything that you need. Okay, so he's wanting you to start giving him direction on anything that you need. So if there's things that you want in your life, now I'm not saying like you want to win the lottery, but like if there's things that you need, like you need more protection, or you want certain abilities to open up, or anything like this, then you can ask him for that. And you can, okay, so he's saying that ask him as well for advice for your life. If you're needing help with which direction you need to go, or there's certain decisions that you're not sure about, he's the one that you can ask. Okay, so he's saying that when you do that, you can either he's saying that he can hear you all the time, so when you're doing it, it's easy for you to do that. Just make it clear. If you're saying it in your head, you make it very clear, so you wouldn't be like sitting watching TV and you would say it. You would sit down and make it clear to him what you're saying. So he's saying that because he wants to start working with you. He wants to start working with you more closely now. But he's saying it takes your participation for that to start happening, to actually start working together. Because he has to be responsive to what your needs are. So he wants you to start asking much more about direction, and about asking him to help you in taking you in the right path. So there's some reason that he's there. There's some reason, because something's coming up soon. You've got some change that's coming up soon. Okay, so what he's saying is there's something that's there, okay? But there's something that's there that's coming up soon, but you need to work with him to get there. So he's going to take you to it. And when I say there's something there, it's like he's going to guide you to a certain stage in your life. And when you get there, I don't know exactly what it is, but it feels big. It's like you're going somewhere and then the energy goes big. It's like the energy goes out a lot. So he's going to help guide you there, but he's saying that you need to start work. Okay, so he's saying that you need to start working together with him. It's not just because you don't just need to start working together for him to actually get you there. Well, you do and you don't. It's the same thing. He'll get you there, but for him to get you there, you have to learn how to start working with him as well. You need to learn how to start working to get like together as a pair, as a team, if you want to call it that. And that's part of it, because this thing, this whatever it is, whatever this big energy represents in your life, you can't actually, it'll not be able to happen unless you learn how to work with him. So that's what's going on there. They're just saying, your guides just said that he's been called in recently, specifically for this. Your guides called him in because your guides knew that this was there was someone there on the horizon, and they didn't pull him in. They asked him to come in so that he could start working with you to do that. So it's something that's recent. That's something that's recent. I don't know if you've been feeling that, but that's something that's recent. The other two guides, they're working like as assistants for him. So I'm not quite sure who the other two angels. I'm not quite sure who the other two angels are. They're not showing themselves to me at all. It's only Mike. I can see Michael standing at the front, and then the two of them are like standing behind him at either side. So yeah, that's some information for you. Yeah, okay, that's that. That's all they're saying about that.
Okay, thank you so much. We have a question from David.
Yes.
Hello.
Hello.
I wanted to ask about kind of like a two-part question. I want to learn more on how to be able to be of service and my gifts as a healer to get out there and connect with more people. And something also was told to me that I should be writing a book that will help lots and lots of people about my experience that happened to me, which was I was taken by reptilians, and they put something in the brain that was pressing on five areas of the brain that caused great worry and fear for like 4 years. And I'm interested in how to feel like I can write this book when it still causes just thinking about having to go back and think about these things to write about it. It seems kind of challenging without any help.
Yeah, they're giving me information on it already. Okay, so I'll come back to the healing part after. Remind me, because I might forget what the question was. But regarding the book, what they're saying is the reason that they're doing it now, the reason that they're telling you this now, to write the book now, is because I understand you've not went through the whole of the healing process yet. But the reason that it's important for you to write it now is because when you come out of that, when you actually come out of it, and when full healing takes place, okay, your perspective of the entire experience is going to change when that happens. Right now, you have a certain perspective of it, okay? And people can relate to the perspective that you have right now, because in some ways, you're still going through it. And when other people are going through something similar, when they look at what you're expressing, right, and the vibration you're in now, they will connect to that very, very well, because they will be in that vibration as well. It will be very much aligned to them. So, and it's important to connect to people and relate to people so that you can help them. Okay. They're saying that's very important for you to know. So after the complete healing has taken place, okay. And what they're saying as well, this is interesting as well. I'll come back to this in a minute, but what they're saying is when the full healing takes place, your vibration, it will shift, it will change. And your, like I say, your perspective of the whole thing will be different. So you'll be able to relate to people, yes, but people who are at a different stage. So if somebody was going through something that's similar to you, when they read the book, and be aware of this as well, as you start writing the book, okay, when you get to certain stages in writing the book, then you will be able to start healing it. It's like this will act, you will allow yourself on a higher level or on a deeper level to start healing, because you're, in a way, you are staying where you are because you want to write this book and the vibration that you're in. So once you write up into that stage, then you will allow the healing to start coming in, and it will manifest in your life where the healing will come. And then you will continue writing the book as the healing's taking place, and you will be writing, your vibration will be shifting throughout, and people will feel that as they read the book. They will feel the vibrational shift that takes place throughout the book. And that is what makes your book so powerful, because people will read the book. And as they are reading the book, they will be in the same experience that you're in when you're not healed yet. And as they read through the book, they'll go through a journey with the book, a journey that you will be going on as you write the book. And they will follow that vibration. And as you heal yourself, and they're reading you about you healing yourself in that book, it will actually cause them to be healed also. So you can see how powerful this book actually is. The book itself is a healing tool for others who have experienced, others who are experiencing what you've experienced as well, and what you're experiencing now. So I think that answered some of the first question as well. Remind me what the first question was, please.
Well, it was relating to the fact that they took me to prevent me because of my healing abilities, and I wanted to be able to connect more, to be of service and help more people, but it seems challenging to get clients and available to people to help heal because I'm having such challenges with finances and just having pay for rent and the basics, food. So it's been really hard right now.
Okay, let me see what they say about that then. Just one moment. Okay, yeah, they're saying they understand that things are hard just now, but the key is here to look at the even though things are hard for you financially, and yeah, and that has a great effect on many different aspects of your life. That's something that you can, okay, so that's something that you can, it can also be included in the book, and people will be able to relate to that. But also, if you look at the aspect of it where it's free, it's giving you more free time as well, where you can put time into writing, because I feel like the writing is very good for you, because it's giving you, it's a way you releasing a lot of this stuff. And there's something about you, there's something about you, you're not quite aware of this just yet, but there's something about you with writing. You've got a great talent for writing. Could be with past lives, but I'm not quite sure yet. But yeah, you have a great talent for that. Once you start getting into writing and you start getting into that flow, you'll be able to do it very naturally. So regarding your financial...
I've been thinking about starting a group at the Gossamer, a book club for people, for kids' books and other books. So maybe that'll help.
Okay, one moment. I'll see what they say about that. Yeah, they're saying that's good. That would be good for you in some ways, because there's some type of learning that would take place with that. There's some way that you would learn how to be a better writer from doing that. I'm not quite sure exactly how that takes place. I feel like there's some people that you're going to... One moment. Yeah, I feel like there's some people that you're going to connect with there that would help you with that, would help you with writing and stuff. So they're saying that that's good as well, because you're starting to recognize like what things it is that you want to do, that you really like, are excited to do, and that's important for you, because that'll help you to change your situation that you're in. And one moment, I'll see if there's any more information there about your financial situation. So
thank you.
They just say that things, they kept on saying things will change. And they say that when things will change, it will happen in a very abrupt, like a very sudden way. Things will change with your finances. So they're saying that it is on the horizon. It is going to change. And you should recognize that as well, that things, they can't just stay the same forever. They have to change at some point. So as they're saying that they know that can drag you down in a way, and it can make you feel bad in a way when your finances are low. But they're saying that'll strengthen you as well, because you'll learn not to give into that, and not to give your power away to that, and to be true to yourself. And what really matters is you, who you truly are, and doing the things that you truly want to do. So I feel like you're going through like a lot of stuff just now, and it's like you're wanting to become a better healer, but this is your way of becoming like a better healer, because you're going to be able to relate to other people a lot more when you go through all of that stuff. They're saying that that's one of the ways that you help in that way a lot. It's like a big way that you help to heal people. It's not so much you sitting like doing healing on people, you can do that, but a lot of it's about you, how can I put it, you're a very good counselor. That's what you do very well also. And you heal, so I'll explain it now. So you're like, so what you're going to be able to do is you're going to be able to counsel people, or sort of counsel people, doing it in a spiritual way. But you'll also have had the experience because of the things that you're going through, you'll have the experience where you'll be able to relate to them very well, and you'll understand what it is they're going through and what they need. You'll understand very well what they need. You'll also be doing healing as well, where you're actually doing like healing work on them as well. So they keep on, they're holding on to this thing with the kids' books, because I want to say something about that as well. There's something about, okay, they've got it now. So they're saying that the kids' book, there's something about you writing children's books that's very healing for you. That's very healing for you. There's something about that, but it's something about the energy. The children's energy is a very healing energy. To be around children, it can be very, very healing, because their vibration is so pure. So when you start to write these books, you're going to connect with that you're going to connect with the energy of children, and that'll help you heal a lot. That's going to help you a lot in the healing process. So they're saying it's a good stepping stone as well, starting to write children's books, because you're going to feel the difference in writing children's, like you're going to feel the difference in writing children's books and then writing your book. And there's such a contrast in the two of them. It helps to keep the balance, because one of them's about very serious topics and about very about topics that you've experienced that are very negative, and the other's books that are very positive and they're very light. And that'll keep the balance. That'll keep you balanced all the way through the whole process. So it's a good thing that you're going to do that with the kids' books. Okay.
Good. I've been around kids driving school bus, and yeah, they're very pure, beautiful energy.
Yeah.
And trouble.
Yeah, that's right. Yeah. So they're saying that that's good, and that by you having gone through that experience, that's how you're going to be able to. That's how you can write kids' books. You understand them already, so it's like you're going to be able to relate to them. You're going to be able to write books, and it's going to be good for them. And I feel like the books that you're going to write, they're also going to. They're going to be slightly different in some way for normal kids' books. I'm not sure exactly what it is. They're not going to tell me they'll not tell me what it is. But they know that there's something you're going to do. They know it. They'll not tell me because they don't want it. They want it to be yours. You know what I mean? Because it is yours. Yeah. They're saying. But yeah, there's something different about them that's going to help kids in some way. It's like.
Oh, that's really nice.
Yeah. Okay, that's it. They're closing down now. Eh? They're starting to drift away now. So,
namaste. Much love. Thank you very much.
Much love to you as well. Thank you.
Thank you. We're just about done with your time. Wish we could keep going, but there is one last question I wanted to fit in here because we did have multiple questions coming in about if NEIL. Sounds like these are NEIL's guides. So questions about who NEIL's guides are, if you're able to elaborate a little bit on their connection to us humans and your role in assisting us.
Okay, just one moment then, because we're going to speak a little bit about guides here. Okay, so they're going to speak. So NEIL's got a number of guides that are always, they're always around them, as are everybody's guides. Who NEIL's guides are? There's not really one main guide. There's one guide that he feels is his main guide because she's very, very close to his heart. They're all close to his heart, but he feels the most. Her name is Ella Sia. NEIL likes to call her Ella sometimes, but she's the one that sort of connects. She's the gateway for him. With a lot of other beings. When other beings come and they wish to speak to him, they'll talk through her because he can hear her so well. The other guides, there's many different other guides. They're very varied as well. Some are not just human spirits as well. And so there is some animal spirits there, but he didn't connect with them so much right now. As a child, he connected with animal spirits much more. And there's a hawk there that he used to see when he was a child. And the hawk used to come to him as a child. So yeah, they're not going to go too much into detail about this now. But one moment, I'll see what they're going to, because I don't want them to keep on going on too long. So one moment, I'll let her say what she's going to say. She's saying, "Yeah, I understand what we're short for time here. So, just some last information here about guides as well. So when you're working with your guides, it's very important that you feel them in your heart, because that is where you'll feel them. You'll always feel them the most in your heart. And when you start to tune into your heart and tune into the guides and recognize, this is important, because some people don't recognize it. They think that they're guides, or maybe they're not there helping them, or maybe they go away sometimes. You must recognize your guides. They are always, always, always there. Excuse me. They're always there, and they always love you. Like that is, you have to think of it like this. Think of your guides. Their job, they live and sleep at their work, and all they do is their focus is entirely upon you. It is constantly up on you, and that is all that they are focused on. Everything to do with you, they are all discussing you all the time. They are going away, and at times they are going to look for people that they can help for you, but they are always there. They are always there, even if they are momentarily moving away from you to bring in new energies or to bring in new beings. Their awareness will always be there with you. They are always aware of you and what is taking place with you, because that is their sole responsibility. So recognizing this first is the beginning. It's the beginnings of forming a strong relationship with your guides, is feeling the love and feeling that they're always there. This is very, very, very important. So regarding the question, so when the channeling was taking place, what would happen is a lot of beings, this is me saying this now, it's more me than her, but a lot of the beings that are coming what's happening is the beings, they basically drift in and out. So when somebody's asking a question and their guides are speaking, their guides come and talk to me. Sometimes they talk through her, but they'll come and sort of blend through me, and that's the way it works. It very much feels like sort of beings coming and sort of waving through me, and some of them come and say a little bit, and some of them come and say another bit. It's very blended, very, very blended. So that's the way it works. Hopefully that's answered the questions that the person was asking. So
yes, absolutely. Thank you so much for elaborating on that. And I suppose we do have to move forward now onto our next channeler, but thank you so much for coming through and providing your insight. We appreciate it.
Okay, thank you very much as well. I'll see what the guys and stuff want to say. Yeah, you're doing. Oh, they're saying thank you all very much as well. And thank you once again for all coming together. It's a great thing that's taking place. So much love to every one of you. Okay, thank you.
That was awesome, Neil. Thank you. And guys, please check out Neil's information in the description and seek him out. He does private sessions and other awesome stuff. So thank you, Neil, for joining us at early time in your morning. We appreciate it.
Yeah, you're welcome. Yeah, thanks everybody as well. Much love.
Awesome. Okay, then we're going to move forward. We have Angie Marias, who has joined us for channeling next. Angie, are you still around?
Yes.
Hello.
Hello.
How are you doing, Angie?
I'm right there. Very good, thanks. Just position myself here. Feels okay. That's okay.
Perfect. Well, we're really excited to have you.
Okay, yeah. We were nervous and we were freaking out, and now it's all just relaxed and chilled.
Oh,
and
good.
I want to maybe thank Neil, because I feel Neil just leveled me out of it.
Yes.
He's unaware of how helpful he is, you know. And this is happening to everybody, really, you know. We are helping people without even knowing it. So
good.
I'm confident
good.
And nervous anyway.
Oh, you're fine. You're going to do great. We're really excited to have you. So do you think you're going to be bringing through thorax today or somebody else?
Thorax, yeah. Thorax.
Okay. Wonderful. Do you want to explain a little bit about who thorax is so people know?
Yeah. Yeah. I kind of know all of you guys almost. So you probably know who they are. These are blue lions in Sirius B. They are feline in nature and are three in one. There is thorax, and he's the male, and he comes through on the alpha frequency. Then there's Bagin, and she's a female. She comes in on this gamma frequency. And Bulba is an androgynous, and he uses the beta frequency. So when I'm channeling, what happens is we'll be talking, and if the whoever I'm channeling for asks a question that maybe doesn't need too much intellectual information, then Bagin will come in, and she will. You'll just feel the shift, and they just shift in as they wish. And it's much like just a co-creation taking place. I don't limit it to time or anything. So, yeah.
Okay.
And, you know, I've taken, what's it, like 3 months or so integration with them, where I've lived in solitude and I've integrated the energies so much so that I'm channeling them already. You know what I mean? They are doing a lot of work to assist everyone.
Yes, and it is incredible. So we're really looking forward to this. So I want to make sure we get enough time here. We're going to go a little bit over today to make sure that everybody has equal time. So that's a heads up for Brian as well. I do have some time afterwards. So you're going to have about 35, 40 minutes. So if you would like, you can get right into the channel and we will be asking the questions in the queue. Feel free for them to provide a message ahead of time or go right into questions, okay?
I will not know what time is, so you'll have to bring me back.
Don't worry. I got you, girl.
All right. Okay, this is very interesting. We have an audience today. Is Thorax here? It is I.
Hello, Thorax.
Yeah. So we just tried to raise a frequency, balance it out a little bit, so that we can come through and we can go to say a few things before. And ask some questions later, but there's a few things we'd like to talk about. It's much like, where do we start right now, because here is just so much that we can expand upon. But the thing that is really taking place right now is energetic in nature. There are energies coming to Earth that are positive, and they are changing all this, the negative. It's almost like it's for a time period, and you're going to feel maybe extremely emotional or extremely high vibrational one day, and you know you're going to get downloads, and because you are being worked on, we are upgrading humanity right now. As you know, humans, we only use a percentage of the brain. This is changing now. The shift is completely changing. Everything is changing, basically. Your attention span will probably be longer. Your intelligence will be greater. Of course, this is all up to you and your choice, you know, but this is what's available. This is what's happening. Okay? Your very essence heightened. The ability to live in the now is no longer hard or difficult. It is now so simple and easy, and you can just flow and go and do whatever you like. And so this is creative. So you can create yourself. And it's very interesting what you're doing, because you're all so different. And are different. So, you know, it's interesting to watch, but what we do on a really generally is we like to integrate the energies with you. So when we channel with Angie, there is this integration going on. constant integration going on. And this is actually happening on your planets as well. Most planets integrating with Gaia now, because she's shifting up. She will soon go through to the fifth, and she will be going with beauty. And at the moment, Sirius B, the energies are integrating so much so that we're probably going to be merging soon with all the beings as well. But it won't be a total merge. It's not going to be a disclosure or anything like that. It is just simply the energies, the frequencies. We are just raising up the vibration of humanity. And there are lots of other races that are doing this, but I'm not going to include them because this is what we are doing. Okay, you can approach your own tribes that you know and your own clans, and you'll probably find that they are doing it as well. They are all part of raising the vibration, raising your vibration, you know. And important because it's something to keep up with. You incorporate it in your life as well, these energies. You have to just fine-tune into your spirit and allow these energies to speak to you. It's simple, really. You can call upon your guides. That these energies are so open, you were able to get into tune with your guides. It's very, very simple. All you have to do is start creating it. As soon as you start creating it, they will step in and create the other half. It's like a 50-50 give and take. We'll meet you halfway. How you meet your guides. Once you meet your guides, your life changes because you suddenly now know that you've got this other person who's assisting you. Full experience, it is life changing. Other than the bad part, all right, the energies are just so beautiful. It is creating you into a multidimensional being, which you know you already are, but now you can really start galactically yourself or in anything you want, really. It's all open and it's all available to you now. It's like a gift or a blessing or something that's opened up for you, or a portal to source. And let's not forget Gaia is a very instrumental in everything we do. Okay, so use Gaia's energies if you do not have guides, and if you think you do not have guides, because those energies in there are awesome. The fairies will come up and play to meet you. It's just a matter of tuning in to a frequency, a vibration, and you. Being your true authentic self is very, very important. But also make sure that you are in a balance. You know, that you're not giving too much of yourself away when you're in the service unto others. You know? Yes, of course, like give it all you got, but you know, hold on to yourself a bit. Going, and you're all like mature babies, and you're blossoming into beautiful beings. But what we do personally, really, what we've been doing in private sessions is showing you parallel lives. At the moment, I am alive, but it's more like we are one. We never leave. So she lives with us, and she lives here. So she knows the densities, and she's going through a lot of celebration. It's exciting. It's beautiful. And, you know, we are created in such a beautiful fashion that, you know, the human experience is so beautiful. You can now go and find out what other parallel lives you have and incorporate them into your now. You know, you don't have to go into your past and dig out the dirt and the muck and the mire. No, these energies that are coming to Earth are new, replacing the old. That is why it is called a shift. So you don't have to do the work. It's a shift. I hope we sort of cleared that up a bit. Past lives maybe are important. Yes, you are important in them. But now you're really becoming something much stronger than you've ever been. Having this human experience is so beautiful, it's so delicate, and it's a gift. Treat it correctly, and it will treat you back equally the same. Allow yourself to integrate with other energies. You know, if the energy does not feel good to you, that's okay. Accept that it's not good and or for you, and move on, and you more energies. Use your third eye. You know, do work on yourself. Clean your chakras, you know, your third eye. Bring up your vibration every day. Make it a choice or a conscious decision to do so every day. Just like you feed your body, feed your spirit. It's exciting. It takes the weight off of living in 3D. And we just want to offer you that perspective. We can go much deeper. And but just a little bit here and a little bit there, enough to leave space for questions even. But, you know, although we have introduced a few people to their parallel lives, they do not know what to do with this yet. So it's now they are just playing the life that they've got. And they still don't know how to integrate the energies in every single day. So it's a learning thing to do. Spend time in meditation. You do not have to go and do the whole ritual of meditation. Just spend time with yourself and you will start to feel part of me somehow. How am I connected to this? Yeah, that feels good. Oh, come along with me for the ride. Hop in, you know, like a truck. You can just gather up the energies and move along with them. It's a very creative time to be living right now. So Angie's a new channeler. She's not all that clued up galactically and like super, super spiritual. She's just very energetic and tuned in to energies and her emotions. So she can help you in that way. When it comes to history and all that, you'll have to wait and let me answer those questions. So having said all of that, I feel like we've covered some ground. Perhaps we can fish more out of what we can share with you today.
Thank you so much, Thorax. That was a beautiful message. And we definitely do have questions rolling in. So would you like to take some now?
Yeah, sure, of course.
Okay, wonderful. Our first question, Jody Runyon was asking on the YouTube chat if there are any messages for her right now, and she says much love.
She already knows the message. I'm not going to channel your son right now, but he's right here. And he's filling your soul with his energies, and he's integrating with you just as you want him to. Jody, you are very aware of what's going on right now. This is a connection that we've had for a while, and it creates a lot of emotion because of how beautiful it is. But for those that do not know what's going on, this is Jody's son who passed away many, many years ago and is now wanting to integrate with her and be acknowledged. And he would like to be for her. And it is difficult because of the circumstances that we live in the third world, in the third 3D. You're going to feel a shift in the energy now because Bagheen is coming through. It's always a lady that understands. A lady. This is Bagheen. And so he says, I love you, mommy. Know that. And he's embracing you right now. That is all he's saying. But it's more of an interaction. Beautiful. So what's going on right now is basically in the spirit, which is raising her vibration and sending her son's energies and in flooding her soul, as Thorax said, with the love. We can take another question, otherwise we will not be able to disconnect.
Okay.
It will just continue for a long time.
That's fine. Thank you, Bagheen. We do have a question from JLo from YouTube, who is asking, they'd like to know if their guides have any life advice pertaining to their current life situation. Thank you so much.
This is interesting. She's a celebrity, isn't she? She sings beautifully, but that's not her, of course.
Oh, I'm not sure if this is the same JLo.
No, I don't have not. A way of No, it's not. No, it's not. Approach things with a 50-50. And that is like in a balanced way. Too far in emotions, but keep it balanced. So you're giving only just 50-50 into the situation. So that there is the answers are guided in a balanced way. This is going to answer many of your questions. This is not just probably for Jayla, but whatever your situation is, trust yourself and your own soul to grow from this and to move on and just allow the light and the dark to come in. You know, give each of them a chance and love them both, integrate them both, and be harmonic in the situation. The now, and watch life just shine upon you and kick out all your worries, and then you'll be able to raise your vibration and chill and really start being your true authentic self. That's it. It's simple, really.
Okay, thank you so much.
Explain that though. Did we explain it correctly? Oh, she will only know because she's not here, right?
Yeah, okay. She's on YouTube. Yep, so. He or she.
He or she.
Yes, okay, well, thank you. Yeah. All right, we have two questions from Pete.
Water. Pete.
Oh, take your time.
No, you may continue. Hello, Pete. How are you?
Hello. I'm doing well. Doing well. I was wanting to ask two questions.
Go ahead.
Okay. My first question is that I am going through a transition in my life, in this lifetime. And I was wondering if I could ask if my guides were to ask me if what I should be doing from this month and by next month of my time.
You're going through a transformation. You want to know what you can do what? If you don't mind repeating it.
Can help me in my path.
Transition?
In
yeah.
Any suggestions?
Of course. Okay, you're going through a transformation. What are you transforming into?
Into a better version of myself.
That's interesting.
Transformation entirely.
Entirely.
In my area.
In your area, is that like a particular place, or is it in your aura area, your vortex, we understand. So when you go through a transformation, basically there's a lot of emotions, you don't know how to deal with them, you're going to feel lonely because it's something that happens privately to you. Nobody understands you really. And you're going to feel sometimes a little bit rejected by humans maybe, or more accepted because of what you're going through. It just depends, but transformation to continue. And I'm going to say this again, introduce a balanced way and a balanced approach, you know, that your emotions don't fly too high or too low, that your opinions of it are not too questionable. just allow it to happen, because it's not only you that's going through a transformation. Everybody is. And it's just a matter of accepting that it is. You know, we are all changing. So change, let it go. One particular thing we would focus on with this here is stay in the present moment always. Because as soon as you say, oh, but I can't do this, and this, oh, I'm not hearing anything from my guides, or you get anxious out of the now, and it hinders you from growing and moving on and transforming. So stay in the now and just allow the answers to come transform you. Be joyful about it, be positive about it, and also balance energies into yourself. Raise your vibration in your meditation time. This is important, that you speak to your guides in your meditation. Integrate your guide into your life. You know, get to know them. You don't have to ask other people for questions, other people for answers. Your guide will just be saying, you know, yep, upgrade, you know, raise your vibration, change this thought. That's what they do, basically. So spend time with your guides more and in the now, in the present. You spend a lot of time with meditation. Yes, you do. I'm not going to expand too much on that, because we can take you way out being right now. We can see it. So we have to sort of cut the question here and just give you direction. You can also have a session with Angie, and she'll tell you more, you know, of how to do these things personally in your own life and what's hindering you. Keep your chakras open, buzzing, you know, stay grounded. The advice that we are giving you right now is for everyone, basically. Your second question is, did we answer sufficiently?
Yes, thank you very much. And my second question for today is, I'm channeling in a sense, but in a sense, I was wondering to know if how is my auric field when it comes to channeling? How is my progress, so to speak?
Okay. It's weird how you sound so far away or almost inside yourself. Yet you're not living out of yourself, deeper inside. We can hear this in your voice. It's somewhat passive. So therefore, if you're going to channel other beings, rather wait and channel your higher self. Find your higher self. Find your center point. Keep your chakras clean. Get to know your guides before you increase in your channel work. Channeling is not something you rush into. It is a responsibility. And there's a lot of work that you need to do to incorporate energies into your life. In others, light. You have to be completely light, you know, and open and honest. Raise your vibration up. Get your energies up a little bit. Get out of yourself. You've got a little bit too much feminine energy. It's almost feminine, but it's okay, it's acceptable. But bring in more confidence in yourself. So there's this part of you that wants to do things, and you can, and you know you can, you know, but you're just have these insecurities. And it's okay to have them. We all have them. But you can choose not to have them. Just remove them. Step aside. People, you know, acknowledge them and remove them and change. Work on your throat chakra more if you want to channel. This is very important because your voice is going to create a vibration for others. You have to, when you speak, be bold. So you have a lot of work to do before you begin to channel. Well, there is no right or wrong in channeling, really. But, you know, you can be a channeler as you are, but there's an imbalance that you just need to work on a little bit. Be bold. Because it's only you that you're afraid of. It's only you are holding on to that is creating fear in you. Just remove that stuff, you know, deal with it. You know, you tend to want to focus on out there stuff as well, but you're still in here. You're still in yourself. So we will offer it again and say, come see us. You know, we'll help you break through these things. It's easy to do, but the work is yours. You always have to do half the work at least and meet us halfway. Total work done. This concept simply applies to everything. That don't make sense to you?
It makes a lot sufficient? Of sense. It's actually putting a smile on my face mentally and physically.
Yeah. Your energy is changing. Yeah. This is the whole idea. Don't take life so seriously. It's a game, and you can play it however you want to play it. The only rules are really, actually the rules are falling away. There are no rules. It's all open now, and you're allowed to play. So get rid of those other, all these things that you're attached to. No, remove them out of your life. Move on. You don't need to stagnate.
Yeah, at this moment I'm at the point of...
Trying to move, I can feel it. You're trying to move. And there's a blockage. So the only blockage is we're not going to blame an entity or anything. We're going to just say, you're the one that's stopping yourself, basically. It's yourself. Love yourself. Nurture yourself. Spend time with yourself.
Thank you so
and
much.
We'll see you soon, I'm sure.
I hope so.
We love
you. I hope so. Much love to my family as a Lyrans.
And to you.
Thank you so much for your insight. We are getting close to the end point here, so we only have time for one more question. And Jana wanted to ask, what is the root cause of my impatience and how do I heal from it?
She can't talk, eh?
She said her microphone is not working.
Okay. you've heard all the advice that we've given today. And what we're going to do is reflect it back on you. The only thing that's hindering you from anything is yourself. It's all in yourself and how you think of yourself. It's all in your field, your energy. You cannot blame anybody else for the cause of your problems. It's all you. It's your problem and nobody else's. Take responsibility for that and apply something to it. Do something about it. But don't blame anything else but you. But don't harm yourself. It to yourself. You know, just allow it. Allow yourself to change. Allow different ideas to come about. There is no root cause of anything, really. People want to, they tend to label like root cause of all rejection. Oh, let's use rejection as the root cause. No. No, this rejection is not you. This rejection is something out. It's a word. It's a thing you created. All right. So, self. You know, it's your own thing to deal with. You don't have to go back into your past lives to find out that it's, oh, it was stuck over there. No. We are now. This is happening now. It's not difficult to deal with, really. If you think about it, what is impatience? You're kind of want to do it quicker. This is because you're impatient. This person's keeping you a long line and waiting to get there to pay. Like, I don't understand your situation, but I do know that the answer is you. Connect to your source.
Okay.
Connect to yourself. And love yourself, and it will be done. Thank you.
Thank you so much for that insight. We have like a minute left for you, but Michelle did have a question about what you had spoken about before briefly. So if you're able to summarize this quickly, so we're able to move forward. Michelle was asking what the benefits are of merging with a parallel life.
Okay. Look at Angie. She's merged in with us. So she can't create ideas and all that on her own. She's incorporating our energies for the specific reason of channeling. Okay, but having all these lives is that you can shift in and out of them, and they will also help you raise your vibration. It'll cause also, it'll help you to get used to the fourth densities as well. And it'll take you out of the third, you know, and the issues and everything that's going on in the world. That is not really part of you. You know what I mean? There is so much benefit in integrating energies into your life. You're going to meet more of your parallel lives soon. Because you've already met a few of them. But if you haven't seen any benefits from it, that is simply because you're not doing much integration in the private time. That's what we leave it at. We could speak later, Michelle.
Okay. She says thank you. So Thorax, Begin, and Balba, and Angie, thank you so much today for channeling for us. We're going to have to move forward. We really appreciate your insight today.
Thank you so much. Have a good evening.
Please, for anyone who would like to book a private session with Angie, She is offering private sessions and they are a lot of fun. You can contact her with the links provided below in the description. So thank you again, Angie, for joining us today. That was awesome, especially for your first time. So moving forward then, we're going to have Brian Sims next. And Brian, I'm going to give you the full time. Stay a little bit later. How you doing, Brian?
Good, good. Can you guys hear me okay?
Sure can.
Good, good. Yes, I'm going to bring through a tall blonde Nordic named Fonti. And Fonti is what I've been connecting with the past month. Is I've kept it kind of secret. I haven't really told anyone that much about him. But I've done some channelings on him, and I wanted to bring him through to you guys. And I want you to be able to ask any question. And I ask the questions to please be very directed, not so much very general, like, do I have any messages for me? Or I want really specific. He wants, and I can state that you can feel it's more of a, this is for you, this is your time. So please ask the really deep questions that you really want to delve into. And it can be anywhere from extraterrestrial connections to shadow work, to healing the parts of the life, the past lives, just feeling that energy of or stuck energy or where you feel stuck at in your life. Please just, you know what I mean? Just really bring that through to ask, because this is your time, dear friend. You see?
Okay, beautiful. Thank you, Brian. We have quite a few questions lined up already in the queue, so I will
just give me a minute. Definitely go from there. Yes, just give me a second here to really connect with this one.
Take your time. Thank you.
Greetings, dear friends.
Hello, Fonti. How are you doing?
Very good. Please direction, dear friend.
Yes. Thank you for joining us today. We have some questions already. We had a question from on YouTube chat. Diva Jules is the username, asking, I'd like to know who or what it is that I've been feeling on my right side of my shoulder area. Thank you and much love.
Diva Jules, is that how you say this?
Yeah, it's Diva J-U-L-Z.
Do this individual feeling the, you would say an entity, or what you would call the pain?
It sounded more like an entity feeling. Diva Jules was also talking about having some tingling, strange sensation in the ear as well.
Ah, ringing in the ear?
I don't believe it was ringing. It sounded more like it was a tickling or it was something along that line.
Yes, the more specific that you can be, the more that we can identify it. Get right to the point.
But
what we can suggest is that what you're feeling at this time or picking up is the presence of the body, the energies of the planet affecting that side to get your attention. There is something that either you can feel, it's an indication that the body is either adjusting to a vibration, or it is which we would say getting your attention. It is, it can be through either a slight pain, what you call the ringing in the ears. It is something of pressure transitioning, the popping, the pressure within the ear, which would indicate that it is, it can be viewed as a download. It can be viewed as just that of elements of the feeling, the energies that are shifting and changing within the body. And it is more on the energetic level.
Okay.
Nothing to be alarmed at, but yet it is that, that which is getting your attention in the moment.
Okay.
It will persist for, it can persist for some time until the body realigns and adjusts to itself. It's more natural state, you see.
All right. Yeah. She was saying that it was like fluttering in her left ear as well as the sensation on the right side of the shoulder. So that does sound like it lines up.
Yes.
So thank you. Okay, wonderful. We have a question next from Lori. Lori B on YouTube was asking, when providing love, how do all lightworkers engage with somebody who is enraged?
Lori B. The love. How to engage with someone that is enraged. The simplest thing would be to walk away, to allow that individual to calm, to self-reflect. That would be one suggestion. You can look at it as that may intensify the situation, but most likely when there is love from the unity of that which is being given, the other being enraged because of your vibration or that which you, they see as a threat, it is that which they are not used to. But yet whatever stirs within them, whatever is causing this rage within them, it is usually something, the self-reflection that they mislook at. And so in doing so, that individual must allow themselves the time to self-evaluation, to find it within themselves of why they're feeling this way. And so the best thing to one can do is for your energy is to allow that person to have their space. Somehow find the where they can relax and to self-reflect on what is that they are raging about. Because this is their way to, yes, you could stay there in their presence and allow them to vent. But yet, if it helps you in some way, but if you do not desire to feel that rage, to feel what they're feeling, you can simply walk away. Find that ability to allow them their space, to allow that anger to reside, you see.
Okay, thank you very much. Yes, that's important. Okay, we have a question next from Christine. Are you able to unmute?
Yes. Greetings. Hello. And thank you. Hello.
Greetings, Christine.
I have been sending Reiki healing to a friend, and when I've asked him if it's been helping any, he tells, the way he talks, he doesn't feel a difference. I mean, he has a bone degenerative, one of those illnesses in the bone, and he's always in pain, and so is his dog. His dog has gone blind. So why is it that my healing, remote healing, hasn't been helping him, you know, relieve the pain or not? Is it him? Is it his choice?
It is what you would say. Ultimately, yes, it is his choice. It is how much he allows himself to heal. He may be over analyzing the information, what you call the energy, because when you say you asked him, has he received it? The mind starts to work, and then he starts to try to feel it, and it becomes more of an analytical. It becomes overthinking about it. It's more to do with the feeling and how the energy flows in through the body and through the chakra system. It is that which is the energy where it may go. It is you putting your intent out there to do the healing, to the long distance healing, but is really ultimately how he connects to it, how it he allows himself to feel it. It's not what you're doing is right or wrong, or that what you're doing is what you would say not helping, which your intention is of love. So it is going toward him, but yet if there's a blockage within him that's not allowing him to, for him to express that, or to something that he's which we call overthinking about it, or something that can also be a block, that can cause a block.
So from what I understand with Reiki is that the energy goes to the individual and it removes those blocks, though slowly. So I'm not understanding, because I've been doing this for years. So I'm wondering if I should redirect my energies then towards another person who, you know, could use it better.
Always your intention is the most important. So even however you are giving it, it's always up to the individual on how much they allow themselves to receive it. If for some instant that he is not actually getting the full amount, there's still something that he is blocked within him, that even what you're giving him is not getting fully to him. But yet your words, your compassion, there's other ways of healing that can reach him to a certain level. But ultimately, it may not be the best, or what I'm saying at the time, it may not be the energy that is meant for him at that time, you see? He may need a certain direction or another way of allowing the healing to come to him, you see?
If I mentioned this to him, because he seems to be a spiritual person, in that he sends me healing whenever he feels, you know, or he says he does whenever he feels I need it. But see, I'm trying to figure out a way to enable him to do better. But if this is his choice, then I don't want to interfere with his choice either.
Allow him to feel what you would call space for himself, yes, but allow him what you would say the, what we would call it, the alternatives. Allow if that which you have thought of or have even thought about to give him the possibility that there are other alternatives also that may just reach him from a different point of view. And this is where your patience comes in. We know that you doubt it sometimes, and it can be frustrating. We hear it in your voice.
Then I have a Reiki crystal grid, which I have set up for him underneath my amethyst geode. And I'm wondering if just doing a blessing daily is enough, instead of spending, you know, so much time working by sending them all this
energy.
Yeah.
Yes.
I'm wondering if that would be constant enough and just daily, you know, reactivating the chakra or the Reiki.
It's not that you have to continue doing it. It's almost like you're just your thoughts every once in a while, which you would call even prayers. But it might be for him that it might take another route for him to accept it more, you see?
So is it?
But it's also his belief system. So it really comes down to how he is allowing himself to really believe in it and to feel it. It's really a feeling.
But isn't part of the Reiki where one of the symbols erases the past lives or the misconceptions one has in this life? Is it one of the symbols for that?
This is again, this is how he perceives it. If the energy, if he has what you're trying to break through his blockages.
Resistance, correct? Yes. Yes.
So you're using the energy that you're directing with your thoughts, with your emotions, your intent to do this for him in a way. You see?
Yeah.
So from one perspective, he's maybe over analyzing it from the mind. He may be blocking it himself through a belief that, it hasn't happened the way that he expected at the right time. And so from that point of view, from his perspective, though he's perceiving it as, nothing's happening, a part of him maybe not believing it fully and accepting it fully.
Okay. So on another level, I'm going to have to figure out how to get through his resistance.
It's really about him allowing himself to trust that he can be healed, that the energies coming to him will allow himself to not judge it, that it has to be a certain way, that it has to come from a certain direction, you see?
Okay.
But your effort and your heart and your love for this individual shows a lot. We commend you for that.
I want immediate gratification.
there's expectation on your side, huh?
Yes.
I see.
Yes. He's a very caring person to other people. So that's why it bothers me that he's always in so much pain.
To see someone suffer, yes. And it could be a test from your part that you're wanting him to heal very quickly, but yet it's still something that he has to accept and allow. It's about allowance.
Okay. Thank you much.
Much love, dear friend.
Thank you so much. Okay. We have a question from one of our members, Xiao. Xiao is asking, if karma is real, then why do most of the cabal members stay in power, or why have they stayed in power for such a long time and they're still in control? It seems as though they're living really good lives for many incarnations on Earth. How come?
Because you believe it. Because you allow it. Yes, you can see it from a perspective that the cabal are in charge, that they run the world to a certain degree, yes. But you also have that power to choose which direction you want to live your life and how you want to live your life, do you not? So even though things on the outside may be wars and famine and death and here and there, you still have a choice. You still can choose in which direction you want to go. Try not to let the fear overtake you. Allow your heart to guide you into what direction that you choose in your life, in spite of fear.
Okay. Thank you for that. We have a question on YouTube Live from Tracy Is Me, is the username. Tracy is asking, are there particular types of beings that are connected to me more than others? And are there any messages from them for me?
Tracy. What do you feel that's around you? When you ask what beings, what do you feel, dear friend? We could say the Pleiadians. We could say the Arcturians. We could say the Sirians. We could say the Reptilians. The list goes on and on. Who would you like to be around you? There's the bigger question. You see.
Okay. Well, thank you. She's on YouTube, so I'm unable to get direct answers from her. So thank you for that. Okay, we have a question from Kina. Kina is asking, are your guides in this lifetime always your higher selves or other versions of your other incarnations of yourself?
Your guides usually come in and out of your life. They're those that have been assigned to you at birth. They're those that will, intermediaries that will come and go. This is that on a case-by-case basis, meaning depends on the situation that you're in. I mean, you will have one or two that will stick with you through your entire life, but there are also others that will come in and out. It's really the perspective and what you're needing at that time in your life. The higher self is the version of the what we would call the spirit part of yourself, and that which slightly knows is the more expansive version of you. And so that is the one that is that spirit self that is you. That is the also a guide, is what you would call the higher self. But also you have other individual guides of other, what you would call angelics and what you would call extraterrestrial and so on, you see.
Okay. All right. Thank you for that. Okay. We have a question from Jenny D on YouTube. Jenny is asking, what is the purpose for my relationship with Nick?
For us to really dive into this, we would have to know a little bit more information on this one.
Okay. Jenny was off of YouTube. So Jenny, if you're able to type any more details into the YouTube live chat, please let us know and we can maybe go back to that question. Let's move forward in the meantime. We do have a question from one of our members, Lewis. Lewis is asking, his first question is the surgical scar next to the implant site on my right arm, was it done by Girk Fitneer?
The what you would say the implants, we'll expand on this a little. This specifically procedure that was done, we cannot say whether it was done by Girk Fitneer or not. We would have to really dive deeper into this and have other connections with this. But what we can specify at this time is that however you view the implant, whether it be from a negative or positive, these implants are there for a reason. These implants are there for what you would call, yes, to a tracking to some degree, but also the vital signs to monitor your vitals. And the reason for this is they have chosen you for a reason, or you wouldn't have been what you would call implanted. They are energetics implants also, that is not so much the physical, what you would call a physical foreign object in the body, but it's more of a energetic energy type around what you would call the aura field. But yet this type of procedure is usually done by many species throughout the galaxy, and they are done for many different reasons and purposes and what you would say agendas. But see it as a positive thing. If it really bothers you in some way or form, ask for it to be removed. And when you ask with very a voice of command, not just like I want it out. Really command with your voice and state that. And usually you will have a type of either angelic assistance or what you would call a certain species that can remove it for you. But if it is to you view it as a benefit, then if it hasn't harmed you in any such way, then keep it.
Okay. Okay, thank you. I found his last name here. Well, I was hunting for it. His last name is Crowell, Lewis Crowell. Just wanted to clarify that. He does have another question. He wanted to know, was his dream this past Thursday night at Human Colony and Astral? He said the woman showed me where her mom would want me on the bed for the hybrid program. I think that was his only question.
Hybrid program. Is this one speaking of being on a bed or a table?
I can't. This was emailed to me. That's the only information I have. I guess he wants confirmation if he's remembering this dream or astral experience correctly, something about a woman showing him where her mom would want him to go.
If you have a feeling of attachment to it, if there's something inside that says that this is right, it feels right, that then go with it, then believe it. If it's something that doesn't serve you, then let it go. If it doesn't do anything for you, if you feel that you have to somehow remember this, or more of the detail, we would ask and suggest that you would connect with what you would call a past life regressionist or a hypnosis, or what a type to go under that would help bring about more depth or more memory into this for you. If this is what you're truly searching for, is more of a confirmation. We can say yes, to a certain degree, there's confirmation there, but yet it's truly for you to explore in depth, you see?
Yes, okay, thank you so much. Okay, we have some more questions. Tracy Hunter was asking on the YouTube chat, I'm very tall for a female. Would this be a connection to specific races as far as DNA goes?
The height of a woman can vary just as a man. But what you're feeling inside, dear friend, if it is your height that connected to certain races, yes, they are what you would call Anunnaki. There is the tall blonde Nordics. They are those that would say certain Sirian groups that are very tall, but there are, and even some Pleiadian groups. But there's so many out there. So to say specifically which one you're connected with exactly, or it would be a variety of groups. And those that you have incarnated and have also been before, these beings, these actually beings that you've been before, you see, they are, it's so the height is what you would call passed down from generation to generation into this lifetime. So yes, if you would have a grandfather or a grandmother or vice versa who was very tall, most likely in your family, you'll be very tall, you see, or considered what you would say as tall. But that connection with others, and it is what you call soul essence, it's a soul memory in the DNA strands, can be passed over from other lifetimes, but yes, so yes.
Okay, thank you, Fanti. All right, we have a question next from Michelle. Michelle Hero, she was asking about reattaching soul fragments in general. She's wondering if that's something we're able to do ourselves. I know shamans and other beings are able to do that. Any insight?
The soul fragments, and what you would say if you're kind of, dear Michelle, disoriented, or that part of you feels disconnected with the reality, and you're coming about, you're feeling this parallel lives, or this extra, what you would call, not extra, but this feeling of belonging, not belonging, or fitting in, or being a part of this planet, or yet the planet is what you would call parts of aspects of you that are trying to really feel to reattach, that you may feel whole again. A part of you feels displaced, feeling, where do I fit in? A part of that, that is a feeling of home, and home is where the heart is truly. It is, but yet you say how to, the question, dear friend, was it that the reattachment or the bringing together of, so that you may feel whole again. So really, it's really the self-love. It's bringing that love so much to overflow to yourself that you're pulling in these aspects. You'll have visions here and there of different lifetimes that you've been in. And yes, it can benefit you greatly. But take what you need, dear friend. Bring it in, that which serves you in the moment. Because if you choose something that doesn't serve you, why bother with that energy, you see? Why try to bring that, fit that into your paradigm if it doesn't serve you? Bring that which you truly feels good to you, that which makes you whole inside, that brings that true essence out, that smile out within you. That is really what you're looking for, a balance within your life, you see? I know it sounds what you would call general, but yet just take the parts that work for you. You see, my friend?
Okay, thank you for that. Wonderful. All right. Moving forward, we have a question from Omar on the YouTube live chat. Omar is asking, what is the purpose of having precognizance, telepathy, clairvoyance, and all other clairs or shamanistic abilities when being connected to sense results in feeling their perceived unappreciated reality?
We're not sure what the unappreciated part. We kind of pick up on why you would say, why these sensory abilities, if we may add? Why do we have them? Why do we use them?
Is that yes. I believe that's what he's getting at. What is the purpose of these abilities, the clairvoyant ability, or the clair abilities and whatnot?
It's a remembrance of that which you've always had, even before your soul, before this incarnation, before your even existence on this planet. You have a, what you call, built in with the spirit. That is what you would call the higher self. That is these extra, what you call an enhancement of sensory, so the five senses. This is where you can smell from a distance, which you would call the clairs. It's the clairs, yes, the clairsentient, the clairvoyance, the clairvisions, all these clairs, these are the gifts from humanity, from others to humanity, which you would call the other extraterrestrial races that have given from their genetics for this, what you call human species, to allow them to perceive beyond what you would call the third dimension. And so why is it given? It's the gift that from the universe that keeps on giving, you see. And why would a human choose to have these abilities? It's to allow you to let you know that you're not alone in this universe. It's to allow you to know that you are much more than just the physical. It's for you to allow you to know that you can expand beyond third dimensional. And when we say that, it's not like that you're just choosing just to be a third dimensional human, but these abilities allow you to perceive into the other dimensions, other realms, which you are already a part of, you see. So with these gifts also takes responsibility, the one that chooses to take responsibility, you see. and how you choose to perceive that, how you want to use that in a practical sense, you see. Much love and light, dear friend.
Okay, thank you so much. Yes, he was commenting on the ability also to feel the pain of these other beings, whether it be, I'm assuming, humans or others, and that is an empathetic trait, which is a beautiful gift.
It allows you, yes, dear friend, it allows you to feel. That's the most important thing. It allows you to perceive into a greater sense of compassion and empathy for other beings also, not just the human race.
Yes, it's very important to help take some of the weight off of others' shoulders, so to speak. So thank you for commenting on that. Okay, moving forward then, we have a question, another question from Xiao. Xiao was asking, in regards to the lightworker communities, she had commented that she's seen a lot of egotistical negative starseeds in these lightworker communities that are managing some of them. And she was asking why, she says, why did our galactic family of light fail to choose the appropriate lightworkers to take these important roles? Mind you, the galactic family of light does also make mistakes, so please don't mess it up next time around. You guys are making our ground crew's missions even more difficult. And she's not hesitating to mention this, unlike others who she says are afraid to ask these types of questions.
Yes. Very interesting, but very well spoken. For some time now, you'll have many, many groups that will come and go, and parts of groups. The thing that we can share with you here is at this time is that there's a reason for this. There's a reason for why the things the way they are. You, one, can view it as a test to allow the lightworker community to become stronger in some sense. There is a reason because, my friend, free will, free choice. Ah, you say, but then it's almost like one looks for perfection. If we had light all the time, would it not be boring without some type of darkness? Not to say that the light communities are striving for darkness. All we're saying is, dear friend, is that sometimes we need a balance. So the push and pull energies is really, it's not that they're intentionally trying to harm or hurt anyone. What they are doing, dear friend, is to figure out how they fit in. They want their voices to be heard somehow. They're not sure of which direction to go. They don't know. Sometimes they feel that others speak above them or put them down. But yet, it's really a perception. If one stands up for themselves and takes command and responsibility, then their voice will be heard. Sometimes people are afraid to speak up due to shyness. We understand. But allow your voice to be heard. Allow it to be strong and bold. So the questions that you may raise, why this community or why other communities have people that don't really vibe with or resonate with a certain group, that is because their free will and free choice. And also they may test this group to see how strong it really is as a group. But yet allow them their free choice to interact with those of light workers. They're still learning as a whole, you see, and as an individual. There's reasons behind that. It is in a way a testing, but yet, and eventually, it allows them, the group, when they truly accept with love and unconditional love for themselves, first and foremost, it allows it's easier then to love another. And those which you would call disruptors or those who disrupt the group, it allow them to feel empathy and sympathy and maybe just more compassion for themselves and for the other, you see. So for this, we would say, dear friend, for what you would call that which is allowed, all things are allowed or it wouldn't be. What you would say, God allows all things. Why is there war? Why is there suffering? Why is the question. It's because it's allowed. It's a part of existence. It's a part of the duality of third dimensional living here on the planet, you see? Not to take away that which you've said, because this is what many are feeling inside. You're not the only one that's felt this. But allow the differences to transpire, because they're growing also, dear friend. They're growing on what it means to be a light worker or how they fit in. So they may do certain things or actions they take for attention. Some are seeking energy, which you would call an energy seeker, or an energy vampire that likes to suck the life force out of others, you see? But really, it's not so much that they're really looking for. They're looking for how do they fit in? How can they contribute in a way? But yet they may be a disruptive to one point of view because they're not sure of how they'll be accepted. So they may choose differently than you. But accept them for who they are and what they are, not trying to change them, you see?
Yes. Okay, thank you so much for elaborating on that question. We really appreciate it. We're getting close to the end time here now, so we have time for at least one other question. We'll see if we can fit in the last one. We got some clarification from Jenny D's question earlier, where she was asking about her relationship with Nick. She elaborated and said, the relationship has been very rocky, but also very passionate. So why am I still attracted to him when I know he is no good for me?
Attraction. What we would call attachment. You may feel that you can't live your life without him. There's something that attracts you to him. So the one thing that you find him attractive to him, admire that, hold on to that. But also the greatest question is, can you see that love and admiration you have for yourself? That's even greater than the attachment you have for another. So why you're having this attachment and why it's hard to live without him is due to the fact that you're attracted to something, a vibration that he gives off. Also, that you see something within yourself that you see within him, or you wouldn't be attracted to him, you see? There's something, a bond there that's holding you together. Yet things can be rocky at times, yes. But find the things that bring you joy within them together. What you would call a relationship can be very testing at times. Find that which brings you joy and expand on that and share that with him. If he chooses to follow, it doesn't necessarily mean he has to agree with everything that you say and do. But yet, and same with him, that I'm sure there are things that you don't totally agree with him and things that he does. But find that compassion, that love for yourself, and it'd be easier to love another. For which direction you want to go with the relationship is totally, it can be up to one person or both. But to make it work, to really make it long-lasting, work together, communicate, allow yourself to be vulnerable at times, but allow yourself to not be afraid to voice your opinion. And state, this is who I am. This is who I choose to be. Accept me for who I am. Allow me to love myself. Much love, dear friend.
Thank you so much, Fonti. Okay, we're pretty much close to being done, but Christine was asking very quickly for the last question. She just wanted to know if you have any insight as to why her arthritis has been worsening recently.
Due to the fact of the aging of the body, it is a part of the aging process. There are certain, what you call, stick with as much organic as possible, we would recommend for the arthritis of stretching the hands, doing things that will that you can work with, or something that along the lines, certain vitamins, we would, what you call supplements, that may help soothe the pain. But stretching as much as you can to help relieve the pain in some way. Certain energy work and healing, yes, but it's totally why it is getting worse is what we call the aging process.
Okay, thank you so much for joining us today. Fonti, we appreciate your insight and you joining us, and we love you.
Much love and light to all. Namaste.
Namaste. Okay.
Hey, guys.
Welcome back, Brian.
Hey, everything all right?
Yes, that was wonderful. How are you doing, Brian?
Good, good. It's got to drag. What time is it anyway? Oh, geez. Okay.
Yeah.
Did I go over anything?
No. I wanted to make sure you got equal time. So thank you for bringing through Fonti. That was awesome.
Yeah. Thank you, guys. And thanks for all the those who stayed. I really appreciate it. Thank you, guys. Much love to you.
Yeah. Yeah. Awesome. All right. Well, we're going to have to wrap up. Wondering if anybody would like to provide any closing blessings. We can do maybe two. I do have to get running to work. But are there any blessings that anyone would like to provide? In the meantime, if you could please note that in the side chat here. Just wanted to note again, please go to humancolony.org to stay up to date on our events and get involved with the stuff we're doing, the book project and everything else. If you have specific channelings, webinars or channelings that you really feel should be in a part of the Human Colony book project, please let us know. We want to hear your feedback. If there has been a channeling that has been extremely profound for you and you'd like it transcribed, and especially if you'd like to help transcribe it, please email max@humancolony.org. And then lastly, check out the channelers we had here today, NEIL333, Angie, and Brian. They all offer private sessions and they all are doing beautiful work. So we appreciate everybody for joining us today. And I'll quickly provide a closing blessing, and then I think we will end for today. So thank you all. Mi ansia sa to kol nti si alia sana haya ta ta okoso to to hanti si a ta sho kol no to to honi at si alta tiki si anta ye si also to to kol to nti si ara na hata ya ya na hauto to kol to nti si a na haya ta sa so ko to to nti si a ya ata so to ko shi hi I ni hi si a si ato ko to to ya. It looks like we're going to wrap up, so stay tuned for more awesome events, and thank you all for joining and for your feedback and for contributing your energy. We love you. Namaste.